Welcome to WP365 Project Document Management webinar. First, a quick introduction to WP365. WP365 is a Danish software company. We were one of the first to move into the cloud with advanced business solutions. Our WP365 product were launched in 2014 following 7 years of on-premise offerings. Today, we offer both cloud and on-premise solution. We've existed for quite a few years, more than 25. We are a Microsoft 365 Gold partner, working closely with Microsoft. We also work very closely with our international partner channel that implements our software in solutions for customers. This slide shows some of our customers. As you can see, we span over quite a few different industries, but all of these customers have something in common. Typically, they always have a Microsoft 365 strategy. They need some governance around the Microsoft 365 products. They need business solutions. They prefer to have business solutions built inside that Microsoft 365 platform and not next to it. That's why they chose WP365. Typically, they also need process support, are very document-centric, and are information and knowledge heavy. Let's see what WP365 can offer in terms of project management. WP365 first and foremost provides overview and structure. It supports structure and standardized business processes. It provides you with a central cockpit for managing your workflows, your documentation, and your portfolio management. You can easily overview all of your ongoing projects and the progress of each of these projects. And you have a structured file exchange and knowledge sharing. WP365 helps you get control of your projects. It helps you work better in Teams, especially using our Microsoft Teams integration. And it helps you with managing all of your documents, which typically are many, many in larger projects. But let's go into the demo and have a look at what it looks like in real life. The first thing you see when you enter a WP365 project management solution, it's a landing page. The landing page is fully configurable and can be adjusted to suit any needs. In this case, we have added some Power BI that are pulling out reporting from the underlying projects. I can also see that I have some personalized items here where I have my tasks and my projects. And further down, I have companies and documents I've been working with. On the top right, we have my tools, which are buttons that will help me create content or elements in the solution. The My Tools will change depending on where I am in my solution because they're context sensitive. To the far right, we have our search feature where I can search in my elements in the solution, or I can search free text in the documents that are all indexed, or I can add or change my favorites. With the My Tools, I can also create new projects, clicking the button here, and that will give me a wizard that will guide me through the process of setting up a new project in the solution. I don't have to do it that way. With our integration, I can also have my projects created from third-party solutions, such as, for example, an ERP system, which is quite a common thing to have done in a WP365 solution. To my left, I have a navigation menu where I have my projects I can see. You can see portfolio overview and other shortcuts to content in the solution. Navigating to the portfolio overview would provide me a list of projects. In this case, they're grouped current to the stage they're in. So I can see we have two active projects, and I can click on the site icons to go straight to the project site. I can also look at idea stage, where I have more projects that are newly created and in the first stage. Let's go to one of the projects. We'll click the side icon and we'll be taken to the project site. The project site is also very configurable. What it will show me from the top, I have a navigation. I can see I'm going from my company, Smooth Running Wheel Bearings Incorporated, to the Invention of Fire project. In this case, projects are sitting under our customers. That is a choice you make when you set up the solution. There are various ways to set up the hierarchy in WP365. Clicking this little arrow will give me a view of the metadata for the project. It'll also show me the stages, the stage model for the project management. With WorkPoint, there can be multiple stage models in a project module. You don't have to stick to the same project model. If you have various types of projects, you can have various types of stages showing depending on what kind of project you have chosen. As mentioned, now the My Tools part up here have changed because now I can add project relevant stuff to my site. So creating, for example, a risk, which will show up in the risk matrix, or creating a status report or a new document or other things. To the left, I have now some other navigation tabs I can click and open, and I can see access to my documents, my emails, my task, project plan, risk, etc. on my project site. The site front page will show me a preview of the documents. There have been several folders. It can be a predefined folder structure, or you can choose to have no folder structure at all. Further down, I will get an overview of my tasks. I can see we have three tasks not started. I have not zero in progress, I have one completed, and so on and so forth. The tabs here will show me a quick overview of what is happening. So if I, for example, click on the ensure budget task, that'll now show up as two completed and two not started. Further down, I can see relations to other relevant solution. For example, I can see we have a lawyer connected to the project, and I can in fact click directly and go directly to the site for that lawyer and get the information around that. The stage model in WorkPoint is a key component. The stage model can be used not only to manage the lifecycle of the project, but it can also include various business process support in it. For example, you can, when you change a stage, you can have workflows kicking off to do other things behind the scenes. You can, for example, have alerts created for other users that now a project has changed, or you can initiate transfer of data to someplace else. There are quite a few opportunities. Also, you can put in restrictions in your stage model. So if you have certain business rules that need to apply to change of stage, you can put that in. So let's try and have a look. If we click on the change date to analysis, this using this button, I now have the ability to change the stage to analysis. That's the next step, but I get a warning because there is a missing quotation document file on the document list. So the system can't find the quotation, which it warns me. This is only a warning. It could be a full stop, so it would simply prevent me to go any further. In this case, I am able to go further, but the system will warn me one more time saying, are you sure you want to do this? Because there might be something you're missing. I am willing to move on. So when I click the next, I can then fill in more information about my project, or I can simply save, and now we're going into the next stage. Of course, all of this is security trimmed, so if only the project manager has the right to change the stage, nobody else will be able to do that. Generally, everything in WorkPoint is strictly security trimmed, so you can manage control of access to everything from the high level of the system and all the way down to individual documents. WorkPoint's approach to document management is that documents should be based on document templates. In all WorkPoint solutions, there are a central template library managing all the document templates in the solution. The way it works is that when the user wants to create a new document, he will simply click on the New Document button on the top or in WorkPoint Express, and from here he will be presented with available templates for the solution. This way, all document templates can be created and maintained centrally by super users with the access and knowledge about managing template. Templates can be both for single documents and for document sets. WorkPoint supports SharePoint document sets, so you can create multiple documents based on a template. Let's have an example. We will click the New Document button and be presented with a wizard. Here we will start with giving the document a proper name. We will choose where to store the created document. The system will default to the document library on the site, but there could be multiple document libraries. That's where you can choose a specific page, site library. You can also choose a specific folder to store it in. This shows the existing ones, or you can create new folders. For now, we'll stick to the root. Then you can choose your document template. Clicking this button will give me access to all of the project templates in the solution. There might be many more document templates in this solution, but I'm working in a project site, so the system will know that and only show me document templates relevant for working in projects. Clicking one of them will give me a preview, which I can enhance to a bigger size, or I can simply just scroll through and see if this is the right template for me. You will notice there are some tags in the template. This indicates that now the system will merge data from the project site or other places in the system into this document. So the document is already pre-made when you create it. Let's see how this works. Now the data system is creating the document and saving a copy and opening the Word document, the final Word document. With the document now open, I can continue to edit it. Notice that certain things are not being filled in. This is simply because that data does not exist in the project site. If it has been there, I would have had it in my document as well. I can now continue to add more information to my document, or I can simply just close it and leave it with this. To the right, you will see WorkPoint Express, which also gives me access to all of my WorkPoint content straight from my Word document. Let's see if we created the document. Let's go to the documents, document list. And here is today's project report, which I've just created. I can now further process this document. For example, it could be sent for review and approval. It could be sent for digital signature or other things. When I click the document and use the Send To button, I get various options that can be configured. These are just some examples. I could also create a PDF copy. I could send for approval, as mentioned. I could send for a transmittal. I'll show that later. Or I could send this document to another project if I want to share it somewhere else. Let's try and send it to another project. If I send to another project, I will click the link. This will open another wizard, which will guide me through finding the project and sending it. Let's search for a project. I want to find the stolen product. So moving on, I will select and continue. Now I will choose what to send and how to share it. So I can copy the document as it is, but I prefer to have a link instead. If I had multiple documents down here, I could choose all of the choices at the same time. So now I have a link to the project sent to the other, a link to the document sent to the other project. Clicking save will queuing the job. It'll happen behind the scenes, and suddenly now I will be directed straight to the Stone Wheel prototype projects, which I chose to share my document with. And here I have my project report. And you can see it's a link, so it's not a copy of the document, it's simply a link that allows me to go to that specific document in the other project. Simply hitting the back button will send me back to the project where I came from. And the project home button will send me back to the project site. Now let's go have a look at working with transmittals. Transmittals are separate sites where documents can be collected for various purposes. And finally, eventually locked down and with no edit rights, so they're safe and stored. Let's have a look at examples. We go to our list of transmittals in this solution. I can pick any solution, any transmittal. Now I'm looking at a transmittal site for carbon transmittal number 3. It is sitting under the carbon bearing project. This transmittal is final and shipped. It has gone through the collect document stage, the package ready stage, and then finally to the ship stage. You can see there are a number of different documents down here, and there are also a cover sheet. The cover sheet is a nicely formatted front page and with an index. This we can see there is a transmittal ID, it's a title, who is responsible. And further down, we have the list of those documents that were in at the time when the cover sheet was created. Now let's go and have a look at creating our own transmittal and shipping some papers to it. we go back to our invention of fire project and go to the document list, we will start the transmittal from here. There are several ways to do this, but this is one of them. We want to click the documents that we want to send to them. If we want to convert these documents to PDFs first, we can do that with the PDF conversion. If we just want to send them straight on, we can simply highlight the documents we want to send and then click send to transmittal. So it presents me with a wizard that allows me for finding an existing transmittal, but I can also create a new transmittal if that's my preference. In this case, we don't want to send it to an existing, we want to send it to a new one we create. So we create a transmittal. We set a deadline if relevant. We set recipient if necessary. We define what is in this transmittal. We can give it an ID. This could also be generated automatically. A description is necessary. A responsible would be this user. And the project has already been pre-filled. Saving creates a transmittal. And now lets me pick what I want to do with my documents. I could have multiple options in here. I could also create them as PDFs on this from this dropdown. We will simply copy them all as they are, and we will put them in the document package. And now we're sent to our newly created transmittal sitting under the Venture and Fire project, and I'm looking at the documents I've just sent to this transmittal. As you can see, the transmittal are in the stage of collect document, as that is the first stage of the transmittal. So from here on, I can go on to add more documents to my transmittal, or I can create a cover sheet when the package is ready and then finally have it shipped. When I change the stage to shipped, all edit rights will be removed from the documents in the transmittal. Now, earlier we have talked about how WorkPoint integrates to Microsoft Teams, so let's have a look at how that works. Let's go back to the project. There are several ways to connect a team to a project or any other site in WorkPoint for that matter. A team can be created at the same time as the site is created. So as soon as the invention of Fire project was created, they could be have created a team in Microsoft Teams. Or it could be created based on content. If certain data was filled into the solution, it could trigger a setup of a Microsoft Teams. Or it could be connected to the stages. So if you have a rule that says whenever we enter planning of a project, we want to create Microsoft team, that could have been another way. Or finally, you could have a manual action. So if the user or the project manager wants to choose for himself when it's going to connect to a team, that could be done from the menu. Let's see how that works. If I click the all action and go to the other, I can see here is a connection to the Microsoft Office 365 group, which comes with a team. So if I click this one, behind the scenes now we have at the system setting up a Teams project. It takes a short moment, so let's look at something else while we wait. We'll go to another project where there's already set up a Teams connection. Go to the front page of the site with the project solution, and we will go to the carbon bearing project right here. The carbon bearing project has Teams connected, which you can see by this Teams URL. Clicking that one will bring me straight to Teams. I'll use the web in this case, but it could just as well be the Teams app. So load my Teams, and it'll show me the carbon bearing project Teams site. Now Teams looks like it does all the time with posts and files, etc. But you have more tabs now. We have, for example, the project home tabs set up. It is important to understand that WorkPoint can define how you should get this set up. So you can have a team created the same way all the time with the same tabs and the same content. This gives me the full WorkPoint experience from a browser. So here I can do exactly what I could do in the browser, just like you saw me doing before. All the tools will be working. You can create documents. You can add data to the solution. You can also say, I want to see only parts of what's on the site. So for example, I want to see just a list of documents from the project site that can be configured on a tab of its own. So this is simply a subset of information on the project site. If I have the user rights, I can also add more WorkPoint features to my site. As you can see, there are several WorkPoint apps in the Teams catalog. So I can add more tabs and configure them to show the data from the project that I prefer. And by the way, while we have been showing this, the Teams connection to the Invention of Fire project has now been created, displaying a Teams URL on the site, which you can then do the same thing as I just showed you, go straight to Teams from here. Another way of using the WorkPoint Teams integration is to use the Teams App Studio to build your own Teams app directly in your Teams. If we go to the Teams, we have here the Teams we looked at before, but down here we have a complete app based on a WorkPoint solution. You can build your complete WorkPoint solution into an app, or you can build part of your solution into an app. For example, if you had a project solution and you want your QA department to have access to only part of that, part of the content, you could create an app that did only that. Now let's have a look at an example of a project solution built as an app in Teams. This solution is a full project solution. It starts with the solution home, where we have a dashboard where we have Power BI to be used for reporting. We have further down a list of companies and projects in the solution. So this landing page could be customized to suit anything. We also have a project tab with my project. So this is a more personalized list where I see only the projects I'm working with. I can always click through to see the site itself for each of the projects, but I can quickly navigate to create a project on this tab, where I will be presented with the exact same wizard as if I had worked directly in my WorkPoint solution. I can also have a look at my project portfolio, where I will see all my projects in the list, and I have a search feature where I can either search in free text, or I can simply click on some of the categories to drill down due to project type. Clicking down will filter my list, and I can go further down in the subcategories. I also have a document search feature. Here again, I can do a free text search for my documents, or I could do just drill down to see what different types of documents. These tabs are designed using the WorkPoint Teams App Studio, and you can create them yourself, and you can define what kind of content and what kind of features should be on it. It's a very good way to get your WorkPoint straight into your Teams environment. You can check out the website workpoint365.com for more information on the Teams app and how to build them. There are instruction videos as well. Sometimes we just want to work straight in our office environment where we're used to. For those users that prefer to work in Outlook, Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, etc., we have WorkPoint Express straight into those applications. Let's have a look at that. Here I have my WorkPoint Express, and I'm connected to my WorkPoint solution, my WorkPoint project solution. And this, I can choose which module I want to work in. We'll stay in projects for now. And I can search for my specific project, the one we just created, was the Fire project, Invention of Fire project, under the customer smooth running wheel bearings. Now, if I get an email, for example, like this, and I want to file that on my project, I will click the email and I will simply just drag and drop the email. The email will be copied to my WorkPoint solution, and as soon as that's done, it's available for those of my colleagues that have access to this project. I could also choose just to pull out one of the documents if I wanted to. Drag the quotation into the proposal folder. I'll do it this way. Now my letter sorry, my quotation has been added to the project proposal. Here we have the quotation. Also note that the email that I dragged and dropped was actually tagged in my inbox, so I know this is generalized in WorkPoint now. This is one way of doing it. I can also create a document from scratch and add it to my WorkPoint solution. So when I have written my document, I can find my project and I can quickly upload it straight to my document list. I have to give it a name. Other metadata can be added as well. Also, if the WorkPoint has been set up to automatic inherit metadata, that will of course happen automatically behind the scenes. The user don't have to put anything in here. All metadata on the project could be inherited as metadata on the document as well. Now here's my test letter. Going back to my demo folder, I can find also my test letter here. And I can choose to send an email and add the test letter to my document. I can either drag and drop it, or I can right click, attach it as a PDF or as a link if I want to send it internally for a review before I send it off. So there are many options here in WorkPoint Express for communicating via email. Also, of course, I can create document based on templates from in here. So right click here will give me the ability to create either a set of documents or just a single document from a template. In WorkPoint Express, you can do all the work you can do in your browser or in Teams, just a little bit of different user interface. But for some people, they prefer to work in the old, well-known office environment, and that's possible. I can, of course, also search free text in all my documents if I wanted to. So this search feature is exactly the same as in my WorkPoint browser or in the Teams environment. It does the same thing, it searches in the same document. There are plenty of more options with WorkPoint 365. Check out our website or contact your WorkPoint partner for more info. If you want to know more, go to our website where you can find both customer reference cases and other information, or you can follow us on LinkedIn. You can always contact your WorkPoint partner or contact WorkPoint directly. We are happy to help.